In this example, we're going to compare the disk slash washer method to the shell method for finding the volume of a solid revolution. So here are the directions. Set up the integrals for the volume of the solid formed by revolving the region bounded by the graphs of y equals x squared plus 1, y equals 0, x equals 0, and x equals 1 about the y-axis using both the washer and shell methods. Okay, so I already have a graph of our region shown here. We have the parabola, y equals x squared plus 1, y equals 0 and x equals 0. Those are just our axes. And then x equals 1 is this line here. So my region R is this region right here. And I am rotating R around the y-axis in this case. So let's start with the washer method first. So the washer method and the disk method are really pretty much the same thing. The washer method is the more general of the two. So let's review what is happening in the washer or disk method. All right, well, in the washer method, we are taking slices perpendicular to our axis of rotation. So in my case then, since I'm going around the y-axis, my slices of my region are going to be like this. And what's happening is we're taking those slices and we're rotating them around the y-axis. And when we do that, it's creating either a washer or a disk shape, depending on the shape of the region. So when you do the washer or disk method around the y-axis or any other vertical axis, you're going to need to integrate with respect to y. So we should keep that in mind as we complete this example. And let's also go ahead and write down the general formula for the volume of a solid using the washer or disk method. So that's going to look like this. The volume equals the integral from some bounds c to d of pi times capital R of y squared minus little r of y squared dy. And here, this capital R of y represents the outer radius of your washer, and little r of y represents the inner radius. So let's start thinking about what is going to be the outer radius of our washers and what is going to be the inner radius. So let's go back to our picture. So once again, I'm dealing with these horizontal slices in this case. Now this region has kind of a strange shape, right? Remember, once again, I'm trying to think about what the outer radius of my washer is and the inner radius. And it looks like the outer radius is always the same, right? It's this line x equals 1. All right, that's always going to be the outer bound of one of my washers. But what about the inner radius? It looks like the inner radius is different depending on where I am in my region, right? So up here, this parabola forms the inner radius. But down here, it's actually the y-axis that forms the inner radius of my washer. So what we're actually going to have to do is split this into two integrals because of the fact that the inner radius changes. So to help us think about that, let's just think about one part of our region R at a time, and we'll start with this upper part here. Okay, so since I'm integrating with respect to y, I'm going to need to be able to write my equations in the form x equals a function of y. So I have a little bit of work to do in regards to that. So my parabola is y equals x squared plus 1, but I need to solve that for x. So let's just do that out to the side here. Okay, so I have y equals x squared plus 1. So y minus 1 equals x squared. And I get x equals plus or minus the square root of y minus 1. Okay, so two pieces here, plus or minus square root of y minus 1. The part that we're concerned with is going to be the positive root, right? Because over here, the x values are positive. Okay, so this is x equals positive root of y minus 1. And then we have the line x equals 1, which is already solved for x, so that's good. So then we can go ahead and set up our first integral. All right, so let's leave off the bounds for a second. I've got my pi. So my outer radius, if you look at my little rectangle here, the outer side of that, the outer radius, is formed by this line, x equals 1. Okay, so I'm going to have 1 squared minus, okay, and then my inner radius, if you look at the inner side of my little slice I drew here, that is formed by my curve here, which I just solved to be x equals the positive root of y minus 1. So root y minus 1 squared dy. And then what about the bounds on this integral? Well, I'm dealing with y values here, right? I'm integrating with respect to y, so my bounds need to be y values. And so I want to look at the y values for this little subregion. It looks like it goes between y equals 1 and y equals 2. Okay, so that takes care of part of our region. But remember, we are thinking about this in two pieces, so let's look at the other part of the region and write an integral to describe that volume. Okay, so now we're looking down here, and if I draw in a slice, and I still have these slices perpendicular to the y-axis, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to think about the outer radius and the inner radius of that slice. And so we're just going to do plus and then our other integral. So I still have my pi. My outer radius is still x equals 1. So I have 1 squared. But my inner radius now is just sitting right here on the y-axis. Right? So that's the line x equals 0. So minus 0 squared dy. And then I need to think about my bounds again. And once again, these should be y values. So this little subsection of my region goes between y equals 0 and y equals 1. So 0 to 1. All right, and this is my answer in this case because I'm just asked to set up the integral. So this was a little complicated, right? So kind of the purpose of this example is to compare and contrast the washer and the shell methods, and sometimes one is going to be easier than the other depending on your problem. So in this case, this washer method was a little complicated because we had to split this into two regions. So let's look at the shell method now and see how that compares. All right, so once again, here is my region R. Now in the shell method, I take slices parallel to the axis of rotation. So here we're rotating around the y-axis, so my slices are going to be these little vertical slices. And what happens is I rotate one of those slices around the axis, and it's going to create a cylindrical shell shape. So when I rotate around the y-axis with the shell method, or any other vertical axis, I'm going to be integrating with respect to x. And my formula is going to look like this. The volume equals the integral over some interval a to b of 2 pi r of x h of x dx. And here r of x represents the radius of a shell, and h of x represents the height of a shell. So let's see if we can fill in this integral based on our region. So let's start by thinking about the radius of one of our shells. Well, the radius of the shell in general is going to be the distance between the axis of rotation, in my case that's the y-axis, and a slice of the region. So on my picture, this distance here. Okay, so in that case, this is just going to be x. Right, a slice of my region is just its sum x value x. Then next we think about the height of a shell, which is, you can simply think about the height of one of your slices. Draw this over here. Okay, so here you can usually just think top minus bottom. So the top of a slice is just bounded by my parabola here, x squared plus 1. And then the bottom of a slice is just y equals 0, right? Just the x-axis. So minus 0. So just x squared plus 1 is the height of a slice. And dx. And then I want to think about my bounds. Now those should be x values in this case, since I'm integrating with respect to x. So I just look at the x values that span my region, and it looks like my region goes between x equals 0 and x equals 1. All right, so this is my integral in this case for the shell method. So it seems like for this particular problem, the shell method was actually easier to use than the disk washer method. So as you're deciding which method to use, there are a few things to consider, and every problem will be different, but the shape of the region will sometimes make a difference. Like here, when we use the washer method, we had to split it into two pieces because of the shape. Sometimes you'll want to think about what variable is easier to integrate with respect to. Or if you need to evaluate your integral, you might want to think about which method gives an easier integral.